MooMooMath. Today we're going to talk about the distributive property. Okay, here's our example. 2 times 5x minus 2y plus 3. That's 10x minus 4y plus 6. Now let's go over the rules for the distributive property. The rules for the distributive property are very simple. We're just going to multiply each term by the lead number or the lead coefficient in front of our parentheses. So we are multiplying. That's one of the biggest mistakes I see students commit, is they actually add instead of multiply. So now let's go back and break this down into slow-mo here. So we're going to take this 2 and we're going to multiply it times each term. So I'm taking 2 times 5x, and 2 times 5 is 10, so that's 10, and I bring down my x. Then I take 2 times negative 2y, so I have a negative, and the 2 times 2y, 2 times 2 is 4y, and I just bring down my variable. Then I take the 2 times the positive 3, so I take 2, bring down my positive, 2 times 3 gives me positive 6. So there is the distributive property. Now let's look at one that actually has a variable with it. Okay, we have 3x, and we're going to distribute the 3x into this, what we call a trinomial. So trinomial because we have 3 terms. So we're going to take 3x times 2x squared. So we're going to take the 2 times the 3, which gives us 6. An x times an x squared actually gives us x cubed, because we're going to add the exponent. 1 plus 2 gives us 3. Minus, now we're going to take the 3x times the 3y. 3 times 3 is 9. X times y just gives us an xy. And the final term, I'm going to bring down my addition. 3x times positive 8. 3 times 8 is 24. There are no other variables, so I'm just going to tack on my x. So that is the distributive property. Check the practice link for more problems.